Good afternoon. Welcome to our faith community of Sacred Heart on the solemnity of the body and blood of Christ. My name is Abigail Mahan. As the living body of Christ, the Church, we are continually nourished by the Eucharistic feast. Jesus remains with us even after his death to be the life-giving presence that we count on. He gives us his body and blood so that we may be one with him and heirs to the kingdom. This afternoon, to commemorate the Feast of Corpus Christi, we will end Mass with exposition of the Blessed Sacrament and benediction. In each pew today, you will find the exposition and benediction rite. This extra event, added to the celebration of the Mass, will give witness to our belief in the real presence of Christ in the Eucharist. Today's Mass is being offered for the return of fallen away Catholics. And if you have a cell phone or pager, please make sure to sign on during this. Please stand and join with me in the opening hymn, number 912, All Who Hunger, Gather Gladly.
Thank you. O God, when this wonderful sacrament have left us a memorial of your passion, grant us, we pray, so to revere the sacred mysteries of your body and blood, that we may always experience in ourselves the fruits of your redemption. Live and reign with God the Father in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Exodus. When Moses came to the people and related all the words and ordinances of the Lord, they all answered with one voice, "We will do everything that the Lord has told us." Moses then wrote down all the words of the Lord, and rising early the next day, he erected at the foot of the mountain an altar and 12 pillars for the 12 tribes of Israel. Then, having sent certain young men of the Israelites to offer holocausts and sacrifice young bulls as peace offerings to the Lord, Moses took half of the blood and put it in large bowls. The other half he splashed on the altar. Taking the book of the covenant, he read it aloud to the people, who answered, "All that the Lord has said, we will heed and do." Then he took the blood and sprinkled it on the people, saying, "This is the blood of the covenant that the Lord has made with you in accordance with all these words of faith." The word of the Lord.
A reading from the letter to the Hebrews. Brothers and sisters, when Christ came as high priest of the good things that have come to be, passing through the greater and more perfect tabernacle, not made by hands, that is, not belonging to this creation, he entered once for all into the sanctuary, not with the blood of goats and calves, but with his own blood, thus obtaining eternal redemption. For if the blood of goats and bulls and the sprinkling of a heifer's ashes can sanctify those who are defiled so that their flesh is cleansed, how much more will the blood of Christ, who through the eternal Spirit offered himself unblemished to God, cleanse our consciences from dead works to worship the living God? For this reason, he is mediator of a new covenant. Since a death has taken place for deliverance from transgressions under the first covenant, those who are called may receive the promised eternal inheritance. The word of the Lord.
Of unleavened bread, when they sacrificed the Passover lamb, Jesus' disciples said to him, "Where do you want us to go and prepare for you to eat the Passover?" Well, he sent two of his disciples and said to them, "Go into the city, and a man will meet you carrying a jar of water. Follow him. Wherever he enters, say to the master of the house, 'The teacher says, where is my guest room where I may eat the Passover with my disciples?' Then he will show you a large upper room furnished and ready. Make the preparations for us there." But the disciples then went off and entered the city, and they found it just as he had told them, and they prepared the Passover. While they were eating, he took bread, said the blessing, broke it, gave it to them, and said, "Take it, this is my body." Then he took a cup, gave thanks, and gave it to them, and they all drank from it. And he said to them, "This is my blood of the covenant, which will be shed for many. Amen, I say to you, I shall not drink again the fruit of the vine until the day when I drink it new in the kingdom of God." And then after singing a hymn, they went out to the Mount of Olives. The Gospel of the Lord. Mentions sometimes that if he sees people leave early, he'd like to stop them and remind them that, you know, only one person left the Last Supper early. Well, I'm not going to do that, but I'd like to tell you about what St. Philip Neri did. You know, he saw someone leaving church right after communion, and he sent his altar servers with candles and bells to accompany the man. Well, the guy stormed back into the church and confronted St. Philip and said, "What kind of joke is this?" And as St. Philip said, "It's no joke. You know, the rules of liturgy say that the Blessed Sacrament should be treated with reverence. You left the church immediately with no prayer or thanksgiving. You're carrying the Blessed Sacrament within you, so I asked the boys to accompany you to honor him." You know, after communion, you and I, we're all tabernacles. where the physical presence of Jesus continues in us for a brief time. And that's why we have the communion hymn, a time of silence, and then the communion prayer, and even the announcements. You know, that's to build up the body of Christ in practical ways. So I encourage you to use this time to say thank you and to express your gratitude to God. Now, the bishop has officially decreed the dispensation from the absence of Mass over as of June 1st, so let's just take a look over the past year. You know, most of us have probably never known a time like it, you know, when churches were closed and we were unable to go to Mass. You know, what we had previously taken for granted, you know, being able to gather as a community of faith to hear God's Word and receive Holy Communion, that was no longer there for us. You know, what were those months like for you? You know, did you miss receiving our Lord in the Blessed Sacrament, or were you glad to have an extra hour for yourselves? Now, did you feel the absence of Jesus in your life, or did it make no difference at all? Did you long to be able to come to Mass again and receive Jesus, or did you get used to not coming to church? Yeah, I think if we're all honest with ourselves, we probably experienced all those feelings at one time or another during the past year. You know, it is helpful, though, for us to look back on the experience of the pandemic and ask what being away from the Eucharist meant to us. You know, we often only discover what something means when it's taken away. So what was it like for you to have Jesus' body and blood taken away from you? What did it teach you about your relationship with God? You know, whether we were sad or indifferent, there's one thing that we can be sure of, that Jesus longed to be reunited with us in Holy Communion. Even if going so long without receiving the Eucharist made no difference to us, it made a difference to Him. And Jesus gave His body and blood at the Last Supper so that He could be intimately united with us throughout our lifetimes. So whenever it's taken away from us, He feels it profoundly. That's how great His love for us is. You know, it's true that when we couldn't gather together here in church, there are other ways that we could stay connected to Jesus, you know, thanks to technology. We could watch Mass on TV, we could watch the live stream, we could continue to pray and read the Bible at home. We could watch, you know, again, we could watch Mass on the television, we could make acts of spiritual communion. You know, all these were ways of inviting Jesus' presence into our lives. But there's nothing that compares to receiving Holy Communion. You know, the Eucharist is the very body and blood of Jesus Christ. And it's sad that over 50% of professing, practicing Catholics don't believe in the true presence of Christ in the Eucharist. You know, it's not just a symbol. It's not just a way of remembering Him. But in the Eucharist, the risen Jesus is truly present. The bread and wine become His body and blood. We receive Him and are united with Him in the most intimate way possible. And through our body, He enters into our hearts and our souls. There's no way of uniting ourselves more fully with Jesus than through Holy Communion. And today we hear the account of the Last Supper told by St. Mark. In Luke's Gospel, Jesus begins the Last Supper by telling the apostles, "With all my heart I have longed to eat this Passover with you before the time comes for me to suffer." You know, in those words, we can hear the love that Jesus has for us in His heart. He yearns to give His body and blood to the apostles, and He yearns to give it to us. And that's why He gave us the Eucharist in the first place, because He longs for you and for me. He longs to be united with us, to live in us, and to be loved by us. You know, how sad it must make Jesus that so many people don't even believe in the Eucharist. How sad it must make Jesus that so many people don't receive this great gift of His love and are indifferent to it. How sad it must make Jesus that He's present every day in the tabernacle, in every Catholic parish, and so few people come to visit with Him. Let's make a point, then, of comforting the heart of Jesus by receiving Holy Communion as often as we can. And when we do receive, let's be reverent, reflecting on the immense gift that Jesus gives to us. Let's also receive Him with great love, pledging that just as He has given Himself entirely to us, we will give ourselves entirely to him. And whenever possible, let's make a point of spending some time before the Blessed Sacrament, praising him and letting him know that we appreciate with all our hearts the great gift that he's given us. You know, another way we can please God is by sharing with others what the Eucharist means to us. You know, if our hearts have been changed, and if we have grown spiritually through receiving Holy Communion, we should tell our family and our friends about it. You know, if we watch a TV show that we like, and if we discover a new cleaning product that worked well, wouldn't we tell our friends about it? How much more should we share with them the most important thing of all, the life-changing encounter with Jesus we experience every time we receive Holy Communion? You know, on this solemnity of the most holy body and blood of Jesus, it's important to reflect on what this Blessed Sacrament really means to us. Who knows if it's going to be taken away from us again? You know, while we're able to approach the altar, let's do so with our hearts filled with love. Let's also be mindful that once we receive him, he remains in our heart and soul so that he can be with us and so that we can share him with others. You know, at this Mass, we will have a real encounter with the risen Christ. He gives us his body and blood in the form of bread and wine so we may be intimately united with him. He longs to give himself to us, and he longs for us to receive him with reverence and love. The response to our intercessions is, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the Church, many members but one body, may we be a people who give wholehearted thanks to God and allow God to build us into a community of faith and love, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who share in the ministry of the priesthood, may their lives manifest God's love to all and their service help people to experience communion with God and others, we pray. For the grace to live in peace and harmony in our country, may God help us accept the differences in one another, understand the gifts that others bring, and give us patience as we strive to work together to end all forms of racial discrimination, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who are struggling with illness, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have died, praying especially for James Robert Andrews, the father of Brian Andrews, we pray. For these prayers, and for all the intentions that we hold in the silence of our hearts. We pray.
Lord,
Sunday, June 13th, will be a busy day here at the parish. That morning, after the 8:30 Mass, there will be a pancake breakfast sponsored by our Knights of Columbus. Proceeds will go towards Meet Life as part of a baby bottle campaign from previous years. In the afternoon of that same day, from 2 to 5, there will be a going-away reception for Father Francis and Sister Francine in the activity building. Please stop in to thank them and wish them well as they move to their new assignments. We will end Mass today with exposition of the Blessed Sacrament and benediction. In each pew today, there's a printed paper to use during this part of today's service.